Dan East says hello. He's up first here on Mad Dog Unleashed. Mike, welcome. How are you, pal? What do you have for me today?
Well, Chris, I'm disappointed. You know, I'd love to disagree with you, but you're pretty much spot on. I've been watching Duke since 78, and no, this was not a classic. It was a good game compared to the rest of the games. It was a good game.
Very good game.
But not a great game.
Not a great game.
We lost because we were 7 of 29 from the three-point line. We got destroyed on the boards. They out-rebounded us. They out-hustled us. We got one of the best big men in the country. We're not hitting threes. Why do you not get the ball into him more? Demand the ball more. He needs to be a little more of an alpha dog and say, give me the ball. But there was just too many selling for jump shots. We have no bench. So when you have no bench, you're tired. Your shots don't drop. When they hit the three, and we can't come up with a better shot than that, Chris, at the end of the ball game. We can't. Kate, it's just like 99. He had a timeout to use against Connecticut, and we couldn't even get a shot off with Trajan Langdon. Now he's got a timeout. We got plenty of time. Set up a play. Who am I to question?
Well, he did not call the timeout. He let the play run itself out. He did not
call
the timeout.
I know, but how about we do it? We did the same thing in 99, and we didn't get a shot off. That was a terrible shot. I know it almost dropped, Chris, but I love Grayson. I appreciate we won a championship with him as a freshman. I'm not going to defend 3 of 11 and 2 of 9 from the three-point line. He played terrible. But he has to play the whole game because we have no bench.
3 of 13.
Yeah, I don't let me sell him short. Yeah, it's 3 of 13 and 2 of 9 from the three-point line.
That is the thing that I never – now, Kansas only played 7 guys too, but that is the thing that I'd never understand with Coach. For whatever the reason, I know he's got a lot of – all these guys are number one picks except for Duval. They play so many games and they blow a lot of people out. You'd figure he'd get his bench more involved. So
right.
When he has to go to him at the end of the year in a big game, he can get more than two guys. You know, Bolden played 12 minutes. The other kid played 13 minutes. You'd figure he'd get a couple of more of those guys involved in the course of the year. I understand that the one-and-done guys are very, very good. And, you know, the drop-off is probably huge. But he never plays that bench that much. Never does.
Not since the early 90s when we had guys staying around 4 years, and that's the key. We need 3 or 4 guys that can hang around 3 or 4 years to where you have those guys that give you 15 quality minutes, and these guys are not out of gas. When we went to overtime, I knew we were done. We're out of gas. But as far as crushing defeats, I mean, I'm disappointed. This doesn't compare to some of the losses we've gone through. We were up by 9 against Connecticut in 04 in the Final Four. We blew that game. We were up by 18 against Kentucky in 98 to go to the Final Four.
Remember the game. We blew
that game.
Yep.
So it's just, you know, I knew it was going to be a dogfight. I knew it was a flip of the coin. We had a shot. I'm with you. I think if you give Kay a week to prepare for Villanova, we have a chance. I'm not going to say we beat him, but we have a chance. But I got Villanova beating. I think they would have beat us in a close game, but I got them taking care of Kansas.
I
pretty much agree with you on everything you said today, Chris, which is unusual. But I'm going to give you your spot on today.
Well, listen, I mean, it doesn't take a genius to break down the game. I think that I know it's a wacky one to say it, and I'll be on this theme all week. I do think that the team that, you know, all weekend and has the best chance to beat Nova is Loyola. Loyola's a very good team. They shoot the ball well. They're smart. Give Wenzel credit. He had that a long time ago with them. I think the way they play and all the things they do and all the momentum they're going to have with 5 great wins, I think they got the best chance to beat Nova. Nova would be a little, you know, be a lot of pressure on Villanova in that game. A lot of pressure. You know, Villanova loves to play. Their fans love to play it. Their coach loves to play it. You know, a little Big East with a little Villanova, no football and all that nonsense. Villanova loves to play that angle with you. You know, God's on our side, all that nonsense. They love that angle. Oh, the Nova fan. I know them all. I know. I live with a lot of them. They love that nonsense. Oh, they can't. They love it. Oh, you know, we don't do anything wrong. Villanova, we have no great one and duns. We have no great, all that crap. I guarantee if they play Loyola, that would be a dangerous game for Villanova because that would be a game that they have to win. You know, to lose that championship game to Loyola would be a very painful loss for Jay to win that second one. But we got a long way to go before we can get there. I just thought that Duke's talent would make for a better semifinal game, and we're not going to see it, which bothers me. Here's Pete in Tampa, Florida, and he's with us. He's on Mad Dog Unleashed. Peter, welcome. It's your turn. How are you today, pal? What do you have?
I tell you what, Doggy, you are the man. I listened earlier to your Canal and Steve Torrey and a great interview with Ray Allen, and I wondered in my mind how many jump shots would he have missed in a big game like that.
Well, yeah. he would have made a couple. I guarantee you that. Ray was a Ray. Don't forget, Ray never won a championship at Connecticut. He was gone. He was part of that crew that always had a lot of tough times. With the big game. But Ray made up for it in the NBA. I just think in this particular game, their 3-point shooting was just horrendous. They shot 7 for 29 from three. And I tell you, when you shoot 7 for 29, first off, that's a lot. I mean, they took half their shots with 3-point shots, and they only made 7 of them. And Bagley only gets 9 shots. That's what would be driving me crazy. I mean, I got the number 2 player in the draft coming out, who I think is going to be a great pro, and I get him 9 shots in 45 minutes, and he's not in foul trouble. Remember, he only had 2 personal fouls. Matter of fact, Bagley did not commit a foul, which is another bad sign. He should have had a couple, just to show you some aggressiveness. But he was not in foul trouble. He played 44 minutes in the game, and he got 9 shots. That's not good enough as far as I'm concerned. Here's Evan in Buffalo, New York, and he says hello. Ev, good afternoon. How are you today? What do you have for me?
Doggy, you know I love you, but I got one thing to say to you today.
Yeah.
I told you so. I told you so. I called you twice last week.
Yep.
You had already signed me up for a
Duke-Villanova
Final Four.
I did.
That was the game you wanted to see.
Yep.
But guess what? That ain't the game you're going to get. That's not the game you're going to get Saturday. Now, see, this is my issue with you. You start watching college basketball a month before this tournament starts,
right,
and then you want to start predicting things. So you, a casual fan, would not know that Malik Newman is a former McDonald's All-American 5-star recruit. Okay,
right.
You wouldn't know that. You wouldn't know that Spee Mikailu holds Kansas school record for most threes in a season. You
right.
wouldn't know about Udoka Azubuki, who's a budding star, 7-footer. Okay, those are things that a casual fan like yourself would not know.
Listen, you're missing a point, Ev. You're right. I wouldn't know the personnel outside of Graham as well as I probably should. But I also know that Kansas is a very good program. I know that Self knows what he's doing. Duke was only favored by 3 points yesterday. So it's not like I would have said to myself that Duke is going to win this game handily. I thought they'd win. I think most of America thought they'd win. I'm a little surprised. Am I shocked? No. You're making it sound like that this is a humongous surprise in my eyes. No, it's not. I know how good Kansas is. They're consistent every year. They played in back-to-back Elite Eight games. They got plenty of good players. If you would have told me before the game Kansas is going to beat Duke in overtime, I wouldn't have been shocked. I may not know the personnel like you know, Evan, but I wouldn't have been shocked. Not at all. That's not fair.
Well, you're still sitting there telling me that you think Duke would beat them.
Yeah,
Duke would
win 4-2. Absolutely.
But doggy, here's my point. All season long, Kansas played in the best conference in college basketball. 4 teams in the Elite Eight. Hands down, best team in the conference, or best conference in college basketball all year. They won the conference tournament. They won the regular season tournament. Yeah, you still thought Duke had a better team just because they have some guys that are...
Well, let's be careful. You're going to give me Kansas State, I'll give you Florida State. So let's be careful of going... And Texas Tech, okay. Texas Tech played 2 games at home. They beat Stephen F. Austin in Florida. They trailed in both games. They beat a wounded Purdue team, and then got their doors blown up by Villanova. Let's calm down a little bit, please. A little bit on Texas Tech. Just a touch. Again... you're right. I wouldn't know that Kansas personnel as probably well as I should have. I'm not watching Big 12 basketball with Fran Fischilla, at 9:45 in Lubbock, Texas on a day in January. I'll be the first to admit. My hand is raised, but I know I saw Kansas in this tournament. I saw him some against Clemson. I did not see him against Seton Hall. But, I saw him the opening round against Penn. It doesn't take a genius to figure out where these teams are. Trust me. It doesn't take a genius. You don't have to be Dick Vitale to know Kansas. I mean, I know how Kansas plays. I know the sort of guys they have. And they're very good. Now, I do believe in a best-of-7 series, 4-2 Duke. That I do believe in. Bob Wenzel in a sec. Plenty of calls to get to as well. Half past, is it Dan Lang? Huber. It's Jeremy Huber with a Sports Bite. Man, don't go.